In this video, I'm going to show you how you can install the call conversion tracking feature of Google Ads onto your website with the help of Google Tag Manager. All and more coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with another video for you guys. On this channel, we do all about data analytics and marketing. So if you haven't yet, consider subscribing down below. Today, we want to talk about the call conversion tracking feature of Google Ads and how to install this onto our website. Now, what is this call conversion tracking feature? If you have a search result, just like on a search result in Google on your mobile phone, you might notice that there is a phone number that you can actually click and then are connected to the advertiser directly. But what if the user actually clicks on the search result, then goes to the website, and you have a different phone number displayed there? Well, Google Ads gives us a call conversion tracking code for our website that can change this dynamically so it mimics whatever is on the ad. We just have to install it. And today I'm going to show you how to do this with the help of Google Tag Manager. So fire up your Google Tag Manager and your ads account, and we're going to get started right now. Welcome back to our demo shop. On this demo shop, I have installed a phone number right here that can be called by our customers. And if the customer actually goes through Google AdWords and comes to the page, he might have seen an ad just like this one where there is a call extension feature. So the user can click on this button and then be connected with us right away. These features can be installed. They are not available for every country, but if you go into your Google Ads account under Ad Extensions, you can look if you are able to install them right here. You can create a call extension. And this will give you a number by Google, which will then connect right to your phone. And if the user calls through Google while he is still on Google, this can be counted as a conversion. Now, obviously, if the user clicks on the ad itself and comes to our page, he will be greeted with a completely different version of the number. And this is where Google AdWords wouldn't be able to count this to a converted user. But luckily, they give us a tracking code that we can install that mimics whatever number is called right here and ports that over to the number and replaces actually the number right here. So we'll be able to still track conversions in Google AdWords. So let's install this with the help of Google Tag Manager. First of all, what you would need is to have a call extension already running. Then you can go ahead and go to Tools up here. And under Conversions, we can set up a call conversion. So we'll go to the plus button, and we are already greeted with a tracking field for phone calls. And then we have three options here. And we will go with the option to track calls that are actually happening on our website. So right here, we're going to go with Continue. And we can give this all a name. We can choose a category. Lead is fine with me, but you might want to change this based on your website. We can assign our conversion a value. I won't do this for now. And decide if we want to count every call that comes from a user or count the user as converted one time. I will go with every. And then there are other configurations such as when you want to count a user as converted, if the call length is longer than 60 seconds, the conversion window is 30 days, and choose whether you want to include this in conversions. And also, you can choose the attribution modeling here. Now, don't worry, you can always change them later on if you choose so. Let's go ahead and create and continue. And then it will ask us, how do we want to install this? In our case, we want to install this with Google Tag Manager, and it will give us a conversion ID and a conversion label. Now, in order to install this, we need to install a new tag that's called Google Ads Conversion Tracking, which is actually not quite right anymore because they already have a new tag template, which we're going to use. And then also make sure you have the conversion linker tag enabled on your page. So let's go ahead and set this up. We'll go over to Google Tag Manager, and here we're going to go with a new tag that we want to install, and this will be our Google Ads call extension tag. We're going to fire this on all pages as our phone number is on all pages of our website, but you might want to restrict this if you just have the phone number on a certain page. Now, as a tag configuration, we're not choosing the Google Ads conversion tracking, but rather
the call tracking, which is a new template, which is a little bit down the page here. If you can't find it, just like me, then you might want to utilize the search functionality up here. But here we go. It's the Google Ads calls for website conversion. This is what we're going to use. And then we need to enter the phone number that is displayed on our website. And this needs to be exact because the script will actually look through the website and try to find these numbers and then replace them. So we're going to copy this and put this in right here. Then we need a conversion ID and a conversion label, which we have right here. So let's copy this. And set up the trigger, which is simply the all pages trigger. We'll save this. And before we test this, we're also gonna configure our conversion linker tag for Google Ads. This tag will also be deployed on all pages, as it's a tag to ensure that our information when the user comes from Google is correctly written to the cookie. So here we go, we already have the conversion linker tag. If you have cross-domain tracking, you might want to enable this, but in most cases, you wouldn't need this, and we can go ahead and simply trigger this on all pages. Simple as that. Now let's go into our preview and debug mode, which will put our browser into a special mode. And if we go back to our page and reload it, we can now see our Google Ads call extension and our conversion linker has been deployed correctly. If you have the Tag Assistant by Google installed, you also see a new tag, the website call metrics. This should be deployed. Now, in order to test this correctly and see if data is received in your tool, you would actually need to click on an ad and see if the phone number changes. But there's also another trick to see if this actually works. And this is by entering a piece of code at your URL, which is the hash and then Google WCC debug. This will put your browser and the code will recognize this little snippet into a special mode. So when we go ahead and reload this, and we're going to close down our Tag Assistant here, we should see some. Now this sometimes doesn't work because it's cached. So we're going to go to another page here. Let's enter our code again, Google minus WCC minus debug, and reload. And this time, here we go. We should see, if we minimize this, a little window here where our Google Ads website call conversion will try to replace this phone number. So we can click on force here and we see our phone number has been replaced. So the code actually works and would change your phone number in the instance if somebody came through a call extension ad through Google. But again, if you want to make sure that this is working correctly, you would need to click on your own ad in order to see the phone number being replaced. Now that we have these two tags installed, we can go ahead and submit a version and publish this to a version that all our users will now be tracked. And this is how you can install call conversion tracking with the help of Google Tag Manager.
Yes, that's right. This is how you can install Google Ads call conversion tracking with the help of Google Tag Manager. If you run into any problems or if you have any questions, please give us a shout out down below in the comments. And if you like this video, then we have tons more on this channel. So if you haven't yet, consider subscribing right over there because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. See you in the next one.